5 cubic inches.
Oh, this, I think I'll be right.
9 for 4.
Well, if it's not, we'll mix the other
one. 9.
Shake this.
How long?
And it's not telling me, it just says shake it.
I'm shaking it.
Me? Okay. Does it look pink on the box? No.
No, it doesn't. It looks this color. I hear you.
If you ordered a gallon of this, it would be 120 or 30.
Okay. Okay, that's it. And this is just foam board. I mean, it's a sideboard. Yeah, it's got actually foam between paper, so it's really nice to slit and glue down. So we'll see. It takes 30 minutes. We'll check it out in the morning. Too many pins. Next time, just enough to hold it up, I think. Just find our way through it.
Say something positive.
Next time we'll get it. Those are above the surface, both of them, so we can put something on them. Okay. And we'll push them down a little bit. All right, attempt number 2. Fewer pins. Metal flashing works good, too, and it's a heck of a lot cheaper than any foam board. And we just hot glued it down, so now we mix and try again. This time I'm using a product I got from Aero Marine Silicon RTV rubber. It's the same kind of stuff. It's very liquid. It takes a long time to dry, especially mine's because it's like a year old. Still works, but barely. You ever seen that movie, The Slime?
Mm-hmm.
Or what was the other one that was like the Blob? You remember The Blob?
Yeah, they're pond.
I had problems with spiders for a long time, and then I decided one day that was just silly, so I ate one.
You ate one?
Yeah.
To break the acrophobia?
Yeah, and it worked. Yeah. I have no fear of spiders anymore. Really. That poor guy gave his life for my fears. They taste like dirt. Got some sound effects. Like a surgeon.
Yeah, I played Doctor. What do you call that game?
Oh, yeah, Operation. I remember that.
Yeah.
I had some friends that had one, but I didn't have Operation. If we're going to be able to get wax out that easy, if we should split the mold in half. There you go.
Oh.
Now go ahead and reach in there and push that pin backwards. Jeez.
Yeah,
Bart. Calm down there, samurai. Look at that.
Oh, gosh.
Getting bent. All right.
Yeah, see? One more hand.
Wow.
You're done?
You're done. Look at that.
That's cool. That came out really, really good.
Check it out. That is nice detail. That'll be more than enough. This is just too easy.
I can't even scratch my ass left-handed.
We got the wires heating up. It's just
look out! Bart's got a sharp
object. That's right. Yeah. What are you thinking about?
A little blood to make that cup stick there good.
Oh, God.
Now we wax it on. It's like Cry Man, wax on, wax on.
Wax. I was just gonna say that.
Oh, dear.
Shit. So much here, so much mind thing.
Oh, that looks good. You know, if we could maybe a light, a chandelier, that'd be kind of cool.
It makes me nervous.
What are you doing, Jack? Well, we're going to do some sandblasting today, but we're going to do it with our little air blaster because we only have a little bit to do. And we put some of that Black Beauty coal slag abrasive in there. It takes a bag and a half. And I love this blaster because it's got this dish that's turned down. I don't know why Harbor Freight's blasters now have these dome tops, a little thing. You're supposed to get a funnel. What a pain in the ass. This one's great. You just pull that up and turn the air pressure on and it'll seal it up. But first, we got to get it up into the boat.
Bringing it over the polisher.
Well, because we didn't think about that till now.
Sure look good on my plate. Chops and bacon and sausage.
Right, you didn't say lipstick. Are you going to work or laugh?
Oh my God, I don't know. I'm going to try and toss both in at the same time here. Well, you know, you've heard so many times the old saying, when pigs fly.
Yeah.
I've actually seen a pig fly.
Did you put him on a trebuchet?
No, he fell off the back of a pickup truck.
Oh, none of that. There it is, all done with coal tar epoxy.
I like the looks of that.
Rosette welds.
Yeah, it binds to the underside plate.
Right.
And then comes up through the second one, so it gives you more contact area to spread out.
Yeah,
right.
So they
this force
both flex
here
apart
out
from each other.
Yeah, get it out away from it. And by doing that, it doesn't leave all that force just at the seam. It brings it in closer
right
to you.
Yeah, that makes sense. I've heard them called keyhole welds and
bunghole welds,
bunghole welds,
yeah,
and you know, slot welds and all kinds of things. But
yeah,
it works.
You can imagine.
We got two fans blowing fresh air back to him. And Bart is cleaning up all of our lead mess. He's doing a nice job. Get all the lead off the steel. And where we can't get it off, we burn it off. Melt it back down to the steel. Well, that rudder post is in and it's looking pretty good. The frames were a bitch to get in. There's the doubler plate in. We still have to weld around the doubler plate and the frames are in. They gotta be trimmed off on the top to make them nice and pretty, and then some welds around the edges and fill. They were kind of a bitch to get in. They're 3/8 inch steel, so they're not lightweight. There's not a lot of room to work up here. We got a cavity back behind here, and we might put a top on this, you know, make this more like an I-beam, and then we're gonna stick a frame in from the back of the rudder tube going on to the back of the boat where that pad eye is, and stiffen it up in that direction a little bit. And then the hydraulic cylinders for the quadrant, they mount out here on this, so we might put another frame from here going on back too to take some more load off that. We'll see. We'll just put some weight on it and see where it wiggles. All right, look at that. They even tacked in some plates for me, so it stopped falling into the keel. I'm used to it, but some of the visitors have a harder time with it. And we finished the welding on our little plate down there. That's the mast step. Put a little hole in the front there, so when it starts raining, you can drain out through that, because this plate actually pitches down. This forward mast leans forward 9 degrees, so we just made that plate lean forward 9 degrees. We still have to put some kind of an alignment bracket on, so we set that mast in here. It just sits down on an alignment bracket and lines up beautifully. That's still to come. And we got our little drip edge cut on that. It's really close. What happens now is the water will come underneath this and it won't run back underneath into the boat. It will drip off. There's this ledge and then there's another one. We want it to drip off before it gets inside the boat. Kind of a moot point really once we get the gaskets on, but hey, we're not gonna have the gaskets on for a while, so stop it from dripping inside the hull.
What?
What? Yeah, you're on camera.
Am I talking to me?
You're talking to you if you're watching the video and I don't edit it out, which I'll probably edit it out.
Peace, YouTube.
YouTube, meet Bart. You're going to see a lot more of Bart. He's actually moving into the house next door.